In this video, I'm going to teach you why here in US nobody repairs anything, and I'm going to tell you my experience because I came from Argentina, South America, and here in US things are different. Usually in Argentina people fix everything, here they don't, and I'm going to tell you why. So I want to pick up all this metal, all this junk from a customer. So I'm using a Prius, so if you can see, and I'm going to tell you how much I charge for pick up all this stuff. But basically here, as you can, I'm going to tell you a little bit about the windows, for instance. As you can see here, the windows, I mean, maybe you can straighten them up a little bit, replace, you know, the glass and everything. But here in US, just if you want to replace a glass like that, you're going to spend at least $50-$100, and it doesn't make any sense when you can buy maybe the whole windows for $250 or $300. So that is one of the things. So the glass is very expensive here. Here I'm going to show you the bicycles, for instance. Here, as you can see, also here we have a little one. I mean, the customer left them in the outside, you know, on the rain and everything, so that is what they are all rusted out. And even the seat, if you want to repair something like that, you're going to spend maybe just for this thing maybe $30-$50 or something like that, when you can find this type of bicycles for $20-$30 used, new, it might be $100. But you know, people, they don't repair anything. For instance, in my case, I am earning between $75 and $150, $160 an hour. So at least to me, doing electric work, also computer repair and all the things, it doesn't make any sense to me to spend maybe half a day just, you know, lubricating the whole bicycle and try to clean it all up and try to sell it later, because, you know, people, they're not going to pay more than $10, $20, $30 tops. And you know, I can use my time just to work in another place and make more dollars. So if you're a low income person, okay, I understand. Maybe if you earn like $5 an hour or $3 an hour, maybe you're outside of the United States, okay, this might be worth it. But here, I mean, people like me, you know, earning that much, it doesn't make any sense. And this is the main thing. So if you're interested in bicycles, all dryers or something like that, you're outside the United States, you want to ship them to you, I can do something like that for you. Just let me know in the comment in the section below. Otherwise, here, for instance, I'm going to take them to the junkyard. So there is a place where they recycle metal. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to go there. I'm going to dump it in this place, and then they are going to give me maybe for all this maybe $50, maybe $100, something like that. And the customer, they is paying me like $300 just to take this. So as you can see, I mean, I go to the customer and go pick up everything. So maybe to go to the customer is half an hour, maybe just to load this up is another 15 minutes, so I have 45 minutes, and then I'm going to go now to the recycle place. It might be another half an hour, another maybe 10 minutes to unload everything. You know, I make cash by selling all this metal, plus the customer is paying me to get rid of all this. So it's a win-win situation. So as you can see, I mean, just for a little of work, I can make more than what everything here is worth. So also they have the this is a kind of a sofa thing, who knows, whatever, but it's the same thing. I mean, you can get all those things so very cheap here. I know when I was living in Argentina, maybe to buy a bicycle, you know, just a regular person, maybe spend like 15 days or a month, you know, trying to save to buy a bicycle. Here you can get them for $20-$30, like I mentioned before. It doesn't make any sense to spend, you know, that time and cash, dollars, as in fixing something like that. As you can see, this one is, I mean, it's decent. I mean, this, the pedal, it looks good. The only thing that needs is a little bit of oil in the chain, and that's it. The other ones are kind of the same. I think one of them is the pedal is broken, but maybe you have to spend like $10-$20 for the pedal when you can buy the whole thing, just like I said before, for $30. So that is a little bit of the story of these type of things, why nobody is repairing anything, because things are so cheap. What I notice here is, here in US, everything that comes from China is very cheap. So everything, all this comes from China, is very cheap. If you have to buy food here, it's expensive. Labor is expensive here. But if everything could come from China, you know, labor, services and everything, it will be way, way cheaper. And in Argentina, maybe if you have to spend for these dryers, you're going to spend maybe like $1,000, something like that, or even more. Maybe you can fix them up for $50, $100. Over there is worth it. In Latin America, it's worth to repair everything that you see here. But here in US, because people earn that much and things are so cheap, it doesn't make any sense. So hopefully this video was useful. If you have any question, please let me know in the section below. If you want me to send you junk and maybe you can resell it in your country, please let me know as well. I think it will be a better use of energy, because this is completely waste, at least here in the US, when you can send it to maybe some other place in the world that they can fix it for a little bit and they can use it. So here it will be just metal. All right, as you can see, I am in the junk place, so I'm dumping everything here, and even the dishwashers and dryers that you see, or the washers, the washer machine, you can buy them used, working for $100. So trying to fix something like that is doesn't make any sense, at least here. So once I dump everything, now I have to go back. All right, as you can see, I'm waiting for the other guy to move. So this is the second time that you have to wait the vehicle. So that way, the first time they know the total, and the second time, once you unload everything, they will wait you again. They will pay you the difference between what you had and what you have now. So that's it. As you can see here, we have another guy. He's doing this like 24/7 almost, but he has a big truck with a cage, as you can see, and he dumps everything over there, and he does this for a living. So that is how it works. You're going to see these people every day. All right, as you can see, I got $68, so very good. Now all I have to do is go to the ATM, scan the receipt, which will be good. So now I'll show you in a little bit. So now that I have the receipt with me, all I have to do is just put it in the cold bar reader, and that's it. It's on the top. Now I'm going to try to show you. You have to select the menu, and that's it. So, and you get paid. Always I forget on where is the code reader, but it's on the top. So as you can see, that is the place. You have to put it down there. It will read it, and that's it. And then you get your cash and ready to go to the next job. All right, now as you can see, I have the dollars here, and now I'm ready to go home, and that's it for now.